as with audio, with video, there's a way to increase the light level. There's a way to make it work. Just not sure . Waiting for scanning. Hope it won't lag. Everything's okay. There we go. Is there some volume? Seems to work. I do have sounds. Seems to be pretty good. Okay, so let's have a look. This is the panel webcam. Basically, what we want to have is an overlay. Oh, I have modifications in there? What's different? Well, I think it's the project itself. Okay, let's look at the encoder. And that's where the magic happens. See that later. Okay, set the output format. I'm currently not looking at the chat room, so if you write something, I won't see it. There we go. This is where it starts. Did I change that? Oh, I think I did that on the other computer where I started by capturing the audio. I'm having an issue with this USB headset where audio is quite good, but there's a lag, there's a delay introduced. Let's raise a little bit that volume. There we go. So I won't work with this issue because it seems related to pulse audio. But for some reason, the audio is lagging. It probably it is right now at like 1 second off. Let's say if I'm going to show you. It's going to be a test for me at the same time. Let's start writing comment. So I'm going to say words at the numbers as I write them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And probably there's delay right now. I'm just wondering why. At least I don't use a webcam right now. I want to have a look at the current sensors. Seems normal. And have a look at the current usage. See? It's not even struggling, so. Seems to work without having the webcam. There's enough room. Okay. So, what I want to have a look at is basically to have an overlay when streaming or recording. The thing is, the overlay is already here. There's already an overlay on the beside the desktop. But the thing is, I'm kind of setting my stuff. Let's look at the right setting. When I put stuff to the right, as you can see right now. So basically what I do is do padding here, add the width of the panel, and then to the 8, the height of the capture, and then use the second source, the overlay itself, and I say put it at 0, 0 and at the width of the put it as the width of the stream, the desktop, and then put it there. Just wondering how it would look if I would move that, seeing that it will overlap. But the thing is, the panel is not transparent, so I would actually have a black zone here, and that's not what I want. Or I could create an overlay that should be set at the top, but that would mean having another source, and I won't want to do that. Watermarks is kind of something I did with the previous version. Okay, let's try something. Okay, I'm gonna say that a watermark could be just a simple image. Thing is, if I put a watermark, I need to set the location of the watermark. So basically, a watermark, I could do something simple. Okay, let's start with something. It's really just an idea. There we go. Private string m water mark file as null equals nothing, but I'm gonna use a file I'm gonna use a file. Okay, let's try that. So I need a getter and a setter. Public file get watermark. There we go. Return M. Public void set mark. File image, and I'm going to say m water mark file equals image. Okay, that's a getter and a setter. By default, it's null. So if I set a watermark, this is where I capture the data. Oh darn, where am I? Thank you. Darn, second time. Where's the page down of that thing? Your side. I wonder if I set here if watermark file not null, then I'll have something. Oops. Wrong keys. Then I could say filter complex and start with that. It will be desk overlay video. The thing is, I don't know which I'm gonna use. Okay, let's start some. That's the desktop. So whatever I'm doing, it will be over to desktop. N source tree will be overlay. The thing is, I can set desk. So I can say source 0. Zero. So the watermark will be set at the top left corner. So if you want the watermark to be somewhere else, you just need to make it big enough. Okay. So video. So I need to define the watermark. Can define the source here. Watermark. Just can't remember how to do it, so I'll have to go look on the web. There's a way to load the watermark right here. Just can't remember how to do it. FFmpeg watermark. I can use the input. I just want to do that. I want to do it directly in the filter. And nope, that's how I could do it. But that's not how I want to do it. There's a padding. That's not what I want. In the filters. I've seen that could be done. Just, oh, there we go. Got it. Something like that. It's quite easy, actually. Just can't remember the syntax. Over. 0, 0. I could just use that. That would be much easier. Oh yeah. So I could say like that. Filter complex overlay 0, 0. So that would be -F image 2 -I, and I'm gonna show you something. M watermark file point get absolute path. There we go. It's gonna be overlaid at 0, 0. So if I look at what I've seen. Filter complex. That. And it should be okay like this. According to this. So I'm gonna say use chain. There we go. See? It's kind of easier. And that should do the trick. Control save. Okay, so now FFmpeg is able to use a watermark. Gonna try something directly without touching the GUI. Already have a lot of options here. Okay, that seems to be good. I think I have something here. Found that out a little early. Oh, darn. That should be connected to the top. No, not like that. Like that. That should be connected here. That should be connected here. There we go. And that should be connected here. Just a little mistake I've seen earlier. Okay. There we go. Does look okay. So what I want to do now is when I start to capture tree icons and get command. Navigate to source, and this is where I build my stuff. So let's hard code just for now. Command point set watermark. Eventually I'm gonna use something. A text field, or I don't know, something. Okay, I'm gonna use a new file. And now I need to look for a picture, which should be easy enough. That means there we go here. Control L, Control C. The file is called logo.png. Paste that slash. it's a matter of just selecting the proper file. And now I'm going to start Screen Studio. Just to make sure I won't break something. Yeah, okay, that should work. Gonna put that, okay. No layout at all. And put that to the bare minimum as I'm currently recording. Okay. Just capture that. Yes, does require less. Start the capture. Okay, there's no error, which is a good thing. Stop recording. Stop that. Then gotta go. No, not here. Go back to before. Okay, that means Screen Studio capture. It worked. It actually worked. Okay, the overlay is a bit too big, but that works. So now it's a matter of upper left. So let's go here. There's a watermark. I'm seeing at the top. What I could say, main width, main overlay. Best thing would be at the bottom, being main height minus overlay height. That will put it at the left. At the bottom of the video, which is where usually you want your watermark to be. And if just a matter of if you want it to the right or higher, usually you want that somewhere. Let's say you put a watermark full screen. Put it bigger. That should do the trick. Okay. Capture just for a little bit. Back to the folder. Yeah, see, it worked. It's at the bottom. The thing is, the resizing and stuff like that, I don't want to do that in the streaming. I want to do that, like, put the actual file itself as you want it. So what I'll do... Oh yeah, I could do that. Look in the overlay folder for any file, graphical file. That would be nice. Just put it there and use that. So I could say let's close that. Go in the main here. That's what I used. Design. Source. Darn. There's already not enough space in there. There's a lot of stuff. Panel. Should I add another tab? This is for the panel, this is for the sources. Audio rate. I would have to add another one. I want to keep it small. There are those options. I could have the watermark here. Oh yeah. Could make some room like that. Work. And as for this, what happened? Control Z. There we go. So what I need is another label. Darn, there's a lot of stuff in there. I don't want to do that, but could be cool. Label that as watermark. And use a combo box. That great. Could I move the debugs and options hide do not hide somewhere else? Oh, could be here. That would be better. Control X. But oh, what did I do? Ah, darn. Created an action. I just want to make sure it does follow. There we go. Here, and that should do the trick. Control S. So I need to load out there. Events. There's no action to do on that thing. Okay, let's go the source. This is where Oh, I'm gonna have to put that in here. That's how to keep the settings. Public string watermark file. And how it this oops, how this works is just read all the members and save them. It's kind of quite easy. What I want to do now is to save that here. Target.watermark file equals CV. Oh, I forgot to name that combo box here. Here. That will do the trick. Control S. And then what I want to do is to... Oh, I need to fill it first. Much higher than that. Should be around here. Edit controls. So I want to do the same thing I do for the overlays here. Get overlays. Should look something like that. Four. F okay, for file in new file overlays. Yeah, I don't want to go there. Just want to see how I did it. Filter, get home, overlays. Ah, okay, I need to do it like that. I'm going to use the same class. Control C. Oh, don't need that anymore. I'm going to say it's a file list. Look for the home, look for the folder overlays. If none are not created, then list file ends with PNG. We're going to support only PNG files. And then get water. Add a none for file new list. If list equals zero. Okay, that's for default. I don't want to do that. Not in that case. And return new list. Oh, wrong key again. So said no, let's not do that. CBO of watermarks for remove all items, just to make sure. Then same thing almost, get watermarks control C control V. There's nothing to do here. Menu, menu, don't want to do that. Pop trade, don't want to do that. If all trade target equals watermark file, CBO selected, and we should not do that, and that should do the trick. Why is it incompatible type? Object cannot convert it to string. Oh yeah, I know what's the issue here, because I'm using Java 8. For some reason, kind of decided that it's not what should be there. Error when loading watermarks. Gonna fix that in the designer. So, watermarks code. Java.io.file. There we go. That should do the trick. Again. Less. So this is an object. So file. S. Oops, my bad. S. There we go. Something's wrong. Oh, okay. Again, the designer. It's a bit annoying. Wasn't doing that before. So I need to go into model and reset. Now it should work. So technically, if I run this, okay, so source logo. All I need to do now is go in the get command. No. Window closing. Where is it? If CBO water one gets selected, index the first one is never good. is more 0. Command set watermark. It's already a file. Say I cannot do that as I need to cast it as a file. Ah, I can. There we go. Now it works. So that should set the watermark on the desktop. The thing is, I'll have to do more testing and actually create something to see if it will work. Let's go home, NetBeans, ScreenStudio here, and the overlay folders. And I need to change that to something smaller. Or could I use a GIF? How large it is? 365. Ah, it's a bit too big. This one is larger. Okay, so let's create controls C. Rename that as rename watermark. But I want to play with that. Oh, I don't have something. Something like change to opacity image, save as. Can I do a resize, rotate, delete, preference, view, side pane? Okay, I cannot do a resize. I don't have GIMP install. Okay, so I need to work with something smaller. Sudo apt-get install GIMP. Yes. Look at the broadcast if it's still on. Okay. The stream is still good, which is a good thing. And what I want to do is to take that. Oh, still I have to wait. Take that file, make it transparent, make it a little bit smaller. Just have to wait. But technically, you get the idea that it should. Create a watermark starting from the lower left, and all you need to do is make it the perfect size to get it to the right place. It's kind of easy to do, and trying to avoid having multiple settings. There's a lot of stuff in there, and I want to keep it simple. Okay, I don't need that anymore. There we go. Open with GIMP. Close that. I do like to work with the console a lot. Okay, so let's start by resizing scale image. I want that 100 by 100 scale. Good enough. Change the opacity. I think it can be done. There's a place where I can't slide. Oh, there we go. Like that. That's good. And then the file, override watermark. There we go, and that's what I wanted to do. Now, if I go back here and I run that, source watermark is logo. I want watermark PNG. I'm gonna have to fix that. Small capture. Stop recording. And then, where am I? ScreenStudio capture. Those were two previous one, and this is the latest one with the overlay. And yeah, you can see it. If we can remove the darn, it's kind of stuck, but you can see it's here. Just can't get rid of the can I press escape? No. Oh, there we go. Ah, as soon as I move the mouse. So you can see the overlay is currently right here, based at the bottom location. And all I would need to do is, normally you want to tag, but you just need to use a bigger, I'm gonna say it, watermark to put it there. Eventually I put more options, but basically here you'll tag as you want it. And if you want it like at the top, just make the overlay full size of your screen capture, and you should get an overlay located where you want it, if you want it there or there. The thing is, I never know how large it is, so you have to be careful with that. But having something like that, like a watermark, it just the bottom, if it can be a banner or it can be something over, oops, over the so that's quite cool. Okay, I think I'm gonna keep it like that. Move to trash. Go back to Screen Studio. Let's change the version. Okay, I just want to have a look at the design. Why? It's kind of here. Something's wrong here. I just don't know what it is. Does work, does work. If I resize, everything is was good. What did I do? I'm having issues with my mouse right now. Oh, darn, I moved something. Sources should be here. How did I do that? Panel should be the last one. Sources. How did I do that? Control Z. Z. See, there we go. Something happened, I just don't know what. That should be around the minimum size. Does work, does work. Control S. So let's say that J-frame, the minimum size is the current size. That's the preferred size, Control C, and that the minimum size will be this. Start that. That seems to be good. Seems to be good. Everything is in place. I'll still get that sensor thing. Forgot about that. Yep. Okay. I think that's good. Run debug team. Commit, commit. Modified. Studio version, everything's okay in there. Added watermark option. There we go. Tools, no, team, remote. There we go. It's available in the repository of GitHub. So let's make a screen cap of that. So I want to share with the world what I'm currently doing. So there's a new watermark feature. Control P. Darn, the sound was loud. There we go. Looks good. So that's it for tonight. I think I've done enough. I'm gonna share that stuff over the web, and thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. The chat wasn't open as I wanted to concentrate on what I was doing, but.